name's Taylor Napier. I play Macklin Ferguson III. Mac is a... He's kind of like a... he's kind of used to getting his own way. He's definitely a guy that has been kind of looked up to by everyone else in the school for a long time. But he started to kind of, as he's getting older, as he's seeing the world outside of Bennington Gothic, kind of realizing that maybe he doesn't want all of this and trying to blaze his own trail rather than the trail that kind of seems laid out for him. I would say that he is ultimately deep down a good guy who is trying to figure out who he wants to be. He is someone who has had a lot given to him, and he's basically had a lot put onto him by his father and through outside sources because of all of the wealth and everything that kind of comes with his status. And I think that in the past, Mac has kind of played up that. He's kind of decided that I have these gifts and these qualities, and so I'm going to do my best to use them to my advantage. And I think he's growing a little bit, and I think he's kind of deciding that maybe that's not the best thing for him to do. Bladen. I think that she is definitely looking to be the power couple, and that is definitely something that she wants, and that she feels like she is entitled to in some ways. She needs Mac, and she wants Mac, and I think she feels like she has to have him to have this status, and to have this kind of queen bee role within her society and her her world. So she definitely needs him. I think for Mac, Bladen kind of fits in some of the similar ways. He kind of feels like he has to have the most popular girl and kind of do that. But I think that there's some issues there with, are they really right for each other, or are they just picture perfect? Oh. I don't know. I am from a small town in East Tennessee. I grew up there. I lived there until I was 18, and then went to a college in Boston to study acting. Moved out here about 4 years ago. Started working in the entertainment industry behind the scenes. Worked in reality TV for about two years. And decided that I wanted to pursue acting, so I'm doing that now. Do acting, a little bit of modeling, kind of across the board, just trying to make it happen. I think people should donate to Bennington Gothic because I think you should always support people trying to do what they love, and trying to make something that's really great and really high quality. And unfortunately, in this business, you have to have money to make things look the way that people want them to look, and to really get your ideas across and get the story you're trying to tell across. And so if you are passionate about storytellers doing what they do best and making stories, and actors being able to act, and writers being able to write, and cinematographers being able to film things and light things and make things look beautiful, then I think that this is a story that you would love, because it's a good story, and I think that we need money to be able to do that.